So, ladies and gentlemen on YouTube, thank you for joining me. Welcome to the Sony Conference. Do not show closed captions. Do not do that. Okay. Hi, guys. Welcome to an extremely awkward thing. Welcome to Total Nonsense. I'm your host, the Total Nonsense Runner. Okay, looks like we're a little premature, but that's okay. I'm glad I found that out now rather than 3 minutes from now. Hey, Derg. Derg got norted! Sorry. What happened? It's actually very simple. Earlier I had an NVIDIA crash, and that
Your dedication will be rewarded.
And that messes with OBS's ability to record. So I had to restart OBS to be able to record. Ooh, so first of all, thank you very much, Micro. Thank you very, very much. That is a much appreciated and very grateful. Second of all, if you want to put that towards anything, that is totally up to you. Otherwise, you can just put it in the bank. Third of all, I'm sorry, because it's got to be super ridiculously late there. Like, the sun's probably coming up there at this point. And finally, if you want to start with the Kingdom Hearts series, there are two recommendations I have for you. First of all, if you have access to a PS4, then you basically have access to the entire franchise at this point. In which case, I recommend you pick up the Final Mix bundles. There are two of them, I believe. I'm not 100% sure, which basically contain all of the games on the PS4. And I recommend you start right from the beginning with Kingdom Hearts 1. The Final Mix version, and then play through the series in order. Unlike some franchises, I absolutely recommend you need to start with the beginning with Kingdom Hearts. It is a very linear story, and you can't miss anything in that. If, for whatever reason, you don't want to do that, there is another option. There's this really weird wacko guy called the Lore Runner who has done a Kingdom Hearts lore run, which covers all the lore from 1 to Dream Drop Distance, and then later a thing about 0.2. So I actually cover the entire franchise if you don't want to actually play them. Up to you. Now, I don't know about you guys, but I'm filled with fear for Harient. Thank you very, very much, Harient, for hitting the half-year mark and for continuing to support me. Thank you very, very much for that Twitch Prime sub, as ever. Much appreciated. All right, I think we're actually ready to go with Sony. Maybe? Yep. Okay.
Please welcome Sean Layden.
That's the what in the world is Sony doing? Why is that your theater?
Hey guys. Good evening, everyone, and welcome.
He's cool though. I'm cool with him.
Thank you for making the time tonight to come to church. This fulfills your obligation for the coming Sunday. For those of you who need to know that.
Oh, thank you.
But thank you for coming out. It's great to see the congregation as large as it is tonight under this single tent. And for those of you who may be a bit apprehensive because you remember that movie Kingsman, it doesn't end that way. It doesn't end that way.
Good.
So, but no, again, thank you. And as you can see from this evening, here again at PlayStation, we've decided to mix it up a little bit in the way that we're doing our E3 presentation this year. You know, we look at what the stories have to tell and the things that we want to impart to our fans here with us and our fans on the live feed worldwide. And that changes our design ideas around what we can do for this show. So tonight, we're going to have, rather than a bombardment of new creative, we're going to take all of you on a journey deeper into some of the key titles we've talked about before, but we're going to talk about them in a different way tonight, a deeper way,
okay.
So you can learn about what's going on with these games and what's coming up in the future. You know, what we look at here at Worldwide Studios with inside Sony Interactive Entertainment, we really want to take our love for gaming and make it sing very loudly. It's a gaming industry, it's sometimes called, but certainly inside our studios, we see gaming as a vocation. It's a calling. It's what we do, it's what we have to do. Our teams of creatives and studios and designers, they have stories to tell and things they want to show you, and places they'd like to take you. That's what we're trying to do here at PlayStation. This coming year is going to be all about those kind of games that we can deliver to you in a way that's going to blow your minds. And tonight, we're beginning here in this tent, this church tent we've created here in Los Angeles, to let you start that journey with us and let us tell you our stories for the next hour or so. So without further ado, it is my great honor and my unique privilege to invite to the stage and introduce to you Gustavo Santaolalla.
He had to think about that too. Man. Okay. Yeah, the acoustics in this room are not good, you can tell. Is this The Last of Us? I actually don't recognize this gentleman. Hey, Rex. Now you're back? You've missed two conferences? Give me a second. So since nobody's saying anything, I feel safe to say it looks like they're going to be showcasing Last of Us 2, which doesn't surprise me too much, especially since that premiere run is almost funded, if I'm not mistaken. It'll be interesting to see where they go with it. Being aware of the ending of Last of Us 1, I'm curious what exactly they want to do with the setting and the story going forward. I do hope they don't pull a Walking Dead, no offense, and basically just have the setting sit in stasis, you know? I hope they move it forward and do something with it. That's my personal want with that. Interesting problem.
Give me just a moment. Here we go. Set it to the webcam. There we go. My laptop's not working, guys. I'm on Pale's laptop today.
Ah, great. I removed Last of Us 1 from the Forbidden List, basically after some very careful and considerate thought. I basically made the Forbidden List a lot stricter, and that also meant that certain things fell below the line, which included The Last of Us. You missed a lot of stuff, Rex.
Oh, I'm sure. How was the PC gaming show?
It was good to above average. And there's at least three games there that I'm... Can you hear me? No, I am not muted in Zoom.
Let's mute the stream, because I'm getting you in the stream. I don't know if I'm getting you in...
Testing.
Zoom, though.
Testing.
Check my volume mixer really quick. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, everything should be good.
Now, I can hear Rax, but he apparently cannot hear me.
Settings. Yeah, Permius, I know you can hear both of us. I cannot hear Zagnus.
And yeah, I noticed that this is obviously done in the style of the tent.
Hang on, let me turn the screen back up.
Don't need that.
Your old man really laid into me today.
What happened?
Another big lecture about my patrols. Don't go here, don't go there. It's funny how involved you get whenever your schedule go out.
Yeah.
She's
Oh, I see.
But not quite the show.
The speakers are coming through my Yeti rather than through the system.
Can you hear me now?
I can hear you now.
Okay.
Not gonna happen.
God. Can you toss me a link to the stream?
Give me a sec.
Discord. Thanks.
Make it 1 week.
Ellie! Hey! What took you so long? Oh, I'm here, aren't I?
I'm so pissed. You know, my laptop is literally just dead in the water right now. Even a replacement.
Don't forget, we need a first light, so get some rest.
Yes, sir.
There we go.
Such a dick. Come on. Why don't you start with me? Okay, I have a very serious question for you.
Just chat.
How bad do I smell?
No, not cat. Chat.
Like a hot pile of garbage?
Oh. Okay.
Oh. So what's up, guys?
How about that? Gross. You love it. Every guy in this room is staring at you right now. Maybe they're staring at you.
What game is this?
Not.
Really? This.
Maybe they're jealous of you.
Interesting.
I'm just a girl. Not a threat.
And then zombies attack. God, die already. Given how much time has passed, Grok6, I'm not sure what they're doing with that. So, gameplay. Scripted gameplay, but gameplay. I mean, I would bet money that this is scripted. And there's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, no.
I got really tired of people who are like, oh my god, he just hates all this scripted stuff. No, those people were not listening to me.
It's just...
I prefer live gameplay.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. But there's nothing wrong with scripted gameplay.
Is my audio fine, by the way?
Yeah. You're a little loud, but that's okay. I think the game
is
quiet.
My mic is literally about 2-3 feet from my face. Let me check the game really quick. Yeah, gain was turned up a little bit too high.
Okay.
Spread out.
I know, right, Illyria? What the hell was that all about? God, I get so sick of human beings.
I think we all do.
I mean, I am human. I am human, so don't worry about it, guys. Ah, UI. I like it. Nice little simple inventory management. Looting. I don't think minimalistic UI is mandatory like some people do, but I do appreciate a good minimalistic UI. Yeah, mega minimal. The only thing that I might say as a complaint, and this is completely hypothetical, is that it looks too contextual. Like, I need to open up the inventory to see how much ammo I have, kind of a thing. Unless I'm just an idiot. Yeah, I'm just in front of it. I'm sorry. Hang on, where's me? We'll go over here. There's the ammo. Anything up here? Nope, we're good. So yeah, there's health, ammo, and what looks like durability.
She went into the grass. Watch yourself.
8 shots. I'd rather have the webcam off, Hardboiled, but people insisted it be on.
Ethan.
What?
Wolf. She came through here. Damn it. Double back. Go.
She's trying to kill them, Jaywalk. They're evil. They're human. Also, that one's checking under cars, so I would... Yeah, I was gonna say, I would be ready for this. In the face. Ready for it. Boop. Just like that. That's exactly what I would do there. QTEs.
Motherfucker!
Ethan!
Nice. Nice
shot. Oh.
Yeah, that looks pleasant. Ow.
I have eyes.
Wow, they have a lot of people here.
Yeah.
Now really the time for that. Actually leaving it in the moment is probably a smarter thing to do, medically speaking.
Mm-hmm.
By the way.
Is it just me? I can't hear any music.
It's a low beat.
You must be ahead of me by just a little bit.
No, I have not, Ryan VG. Although I'm aware of the story. A lot of effort being put into making this look real and cinematic. But you can see how this actually is scripted bots, so to speak. Or not scripted, but, you know, an AI functioning. That's praise, if you didn't catch it. Meanwhile, a few minutes ago, or later.
I told you. He should be terrified.
Interesting.
Yeah. Looks fun to play. I hope it's not incredibly depressing.
Oh, it probably will be.
And then everyone dies. No, that wouldn't be depressing. Everyone dies would be a relief. So they said they were trying to go more in-depth into each game. That was a nice long look at that. I wonder if we're getting even more for it, or if we're going to move on now.
That was a new look at The Last of Us Part 2. We're here live in Los Angeles at the PlayStation E3 Showcase. We're taking a quick intermission while folks move along to the next part of the experience. We'll have a little bit more to share on that later. And I am joined by my good friend, Ryan Clements.
Hello, Mr. Schumann.
How are you?
I'm good. It's such a pleasure to be here at the PlayStation Showcase. And it's going to be a huge night for Worldwide Studios a little later when the showcase resumes. And what better guest to have for joining us about Worldwide Studios than the chairman of Worldwide Studios, Mr. Sean Layden. Hello, sir.
Yeah, good to be here.
I thought you were just on stage. How did you get up here so fast?
We've created this pneumatic tube that I was dropped into and shot right across to the studio here.
Right over here. Well, it's good to have you here.
Well, it's great to be here. And I think that was a very powerful start for our E3 program for this year.
That's right, and there's much more to come, but I do want to zero in on The Last of Us Part 2 here just for a moment. You know, as chairman of Worldwide Studios, you work very closely with Naughty Dog. These guys need no introduction.
Indeed.
And I'm curious, from your perspective, where is their head at when it comes to developing this game?
Where's their head at? I mean, they are everywhere. They're looking at what can do in the next iteration of The Last of Us series. And I think what we saw tonight, I mean, that piece of content was so impactful. I mean, the whole relationship between Ellie and Dina going into the combat sequence really shows that they're pulling out all the stops over at Naughty Dog, and they're going to have a very broad and ranging game that's not going to make you only work at it as a player, but you're going to have to just think as a person.
And get my beer here.
I can't wait to see more of that. That was first gameplay we saw there of The Last of Us Part 2, looking obviously incredible. And speaking of incredible, I mean, Worldwide Studios lately, I mean, it's just been unbelievable. Horizon, you had God of War, which needs no introduction, and Detroit Become Human. I mean, what is the secret, and what are you doing over there at Worldwide Studios? What's going on there?
We decided to spend money on developers.
Right. A lot of ways, my job is just to move the boulders out of the road to make sure that creative talent can get where they need to go, you know, provide backup, provide scope, you know, provide generalized, you know, advice about where we can take this as an industry and as a gaming culture. But honestly, we've got 13 studios worldwide. We try to give them as much creative control as possible and just help support them through to their vision. That's kind of what we've been trying to do here for the last dozen years or so with Worldwide Studios. I think right now, certainly in the PS4 era, you're seeing a lot of that coming into play right now.
That's great to hear that. And you know, I mean, speaking about making fans happy, I mean, I think there's a question that I've been getting a whole lot, and it has to do with God of War. You know, this is a celebrated game. It sold extremely well. It has a huge legion of fans. And one of the things I wanted to mention was, you know, I get a lot of tweets about New Game Plus. You know, is this something that you and Santa Monica Studio are evaluating for God of War?
You know, it's crazy. With the advent of social media, we get a lot of real-time feedback from the fans and the community, and we listen to that. And God knows my Twitter feed is filled up with a lot of stuff that we could talk about here or not talk about at all. But it's all important. We take it all seriously. And New Game Plus is something that came through really strong and really hard through that kind of feedback loop. And I'm happy to say today that the teams are working on it, and we should have some more updates on that. We'll put that through the blog, but it's going to happen.
New Game Plus and God of War.
Someone who miraculously finished God of War.
No, it makes perfect sense.
That makes me very happy.
Because there's so much gear. And so many skills that you unlock, and so much leveling up of your axe and all that. Like, keep carrying that forward to a New Game Plus sounds awesome to me, personally.
It's great to hear that you and that amazing team at Santa Monica Studio.
It'd also be helpful if I ever do a rumination on that game.
Functionality and features that allow people to spend more time in the worlds we build, that's by definition a good thing.
Excellent.
Fantastic. So New Game Plus, that is confirmed, that is coming to God of War. We'll have full details on PlayStation Blog shortly. We have a lot more to talk about, too.
Yeah, and actually, Sean, I wanted to ask you about that. About a month ago, you did something a little bit out of the ordinary for our team, and you kind of came out and talked about the four main games that we would be highlighting tonight's PlayStation Showcase. I was wondering what the thought process was there.
Well, you know, every year we try to let the stories we have to tell design the experience we're going to create.
I'll tell you the thought process right now. Tall, not wide.
On a journey deep into the content, deep into the four big pillar games.
Which I'm with, by the way. It's pretty much the exact opposite of what the PC Gaming Show did. Not a complaint, it's just PC Gaming Show deliberately was like, here's as much as we can show you as possible.
Titles there.
And Sony's going with this.
The Last of Us 2, which you saw right now, through Death Stranding and Spider-Man and Ghost. So
yeah, no FF7, no FF15, no surprises, no announcements.
Have some big flashy new idea come out or some big surprise come out. Come here and sit with us and walk with us as we get through to see the background stories and deep inside of the games we're working on.
Wonderful. And we do have a lot more coming from those Worldwide Studios games in the showcase later tonight. Do you have any personal games that you're most excited about?
Well, they're all fabulous, and I think the teams are really crushing it right across the board.
Fair enough.
But one thing I would say is there's one of the games that we're having out today that will be playable in 3 months. And available in stores,
and that's
our favorite web slinger,
of course,
Spider-Man.
So we're ahead of you again.
A lot of that tonight, and I think the folks at home should be happy.
It's okay. We're on Twitch. Awesome. There's no avoiding it.
Sean, thank you so much for dropping by. Always a pleasure to trade notes with the chairman of Worldwide Studios.
It's great to see you guys. I'll head back to the pneumatic tube station. Though.
All right, please do. All right.
And wear the helmet.
We do have a lot more in store coming up in just a few minutes as the E3 showcase continues. But in the meantime, we also have some other updates for you while we wait during this short intermission. So
I will remain optimistic.
With a look at the latest from the world of Call of Duty.
What? Oh. I don't care. It's multiplayer only.
It's Black Ops 4, isn't it?
I mean, it's probably. Black Ops 4. Multiplayer only.
I really wish I could care.
No offense to anyone who does care. In fact, I have gone on record as saying that I think a fully multiplayer-focused, polished game is a good thing. I just don't care. I care about this bullet. This is, like, the best bullet ever. Like, this is Revolver Ocelot on a bad day.
Huh. They actually didn't bring back Nuketown. That says it right. Unless they're,
I don't know. Excuse me. I'm not bored. I'm tired.
No, yeah.
Get immediate access to Back in Black maps and Call of
Duty. I've been streaming for close to 11 hours now.
Pre-order Call of Duty Black Ops 4 from PlayStation Store.
Welcome back. We are having the PlayStation E3 showcase kicking off in just a few more minutes. We're in a short intermission period here, but we've got some good stuff to talk about. And we've got some good friends as well.
Yeah.
Meredith Molinari and Ramon Russell. Welcome.
What's happening?
That's good to have you guys back.
It's good to be back.
Friendly faces right before the showcase.
Absolutely.
Careful, guys. There's a bumblebee.
So I say we keep this moving here. And when it comes to Call of Duty, we know that a bunch of remastered maps from Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 2 are making their way to Call of Duty Black Ops 4 this October on launch day.
I'll be right back,
guys. What we just learned here is that those maps, those classic maps, are coming to Black Ops 3 as well for those who pre-order Black Ops 4 on PlayStation Store.
Oh, that's pretty awesome.
I really have nothing to say, guys.
Call of Duty Black Ops 3.
I do not care about Call of Duty that much these days.
So tonight, we are actually doing a surprise PlayStation Plus game drop, and that is going to be Black Ops 3. Black Ops 3 is coming to PlayStation Plus later tonight.
Yes.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yes, very nice. This is why I love E3, because not only do we get to share awesome news with our audience, but PlayStation Plus subscribers get a little treat.
Get an extra
little tasty treat.
Right. Little mid E3 supply drop for you there.
Perfect.
You know, we've been sharing a lot of good news. We got to share 5 really cool announcements last week when we did our countdown, kind of ramping up for tonight's big showcase.
Mm-hmm. That's right. We had the countdown to E3, and that was 5 game reveals and updates over a span of 5 days. A lot of great stuff announced. Let's take a quick look back at the highlights.
Yep, Tetris. Oh, I believe it or not, I'm actually pretty excited for this. Days Gone. I don't think I've seen this. What is this?
I have to figure out what happened.
Interesting.
Okay, wake up.
I'm sorry, guys. I know I'm ahead. So sorry. There's nothing I can do.
From the creators of Fee and Flipping Death.
What a miss.
They're recapping the countdown that they did leading up to E3.
Really?
Okay.
Who are you?
I definitely did not just literally splash water in my face.
Please don't fall asleep.
No. It helps me. I think. Beat Saber. Okay. I'm with it. Whatever.
Yeah, it looks.
Welcome back. We're just a few minutes
like
away
something.
From the E3 PlayStation showcase. I mean, I'm.
Oh god, it looks like they really did move people from one area to the next. That's insane.
And we could see the crowd.
That's just such a
the people are about ready to
hassle.
Huge logistical hassle.
Yeah, exactly.
Move into the big event.
Yeah, it was great to see the countdown stuff, but I do think
people.
That there's like
oh
maybe one more
scene.
See
you just made my week.
Cut away to the showcase.
Yeah. Yeah, let's squeeze it in.
Let's squeeze it in.
Okay, so this next franchise boasts
a huge
loyal community.
You have more
of
active viewers
6
than Angry
billion
Joe.
Hours. Incredible stat.
Yeah, they
how
play
many active
that...
viewers are you at?
3. I don't know. Oh no! We had to jinx it. Come back.
I got it back. Oh god, I lost it.
Yeah. I was saying, this isn't just me. I can actually...
Can someone else who has decent internet load up the stream on a different
incredible
tab?
Incredible stat.
Yeah, they play that so much.
A lot.
Oh, Jesus.
I think I might have to switch to YouTube.
Is YouTube even up? I'd always prefer YouTube for this.
Yeah.
I didn't see a YouTube link when I was looking earlier. I still don't see a YouTube
found
link.
Found it through GameSpot.
Hang on, I just left Discord. Oh my god!
Fuck, that's loud.
Yeah, their stream is flat out gone. God damn it, alright.
Here,
I got Discord up. The dark times.
Discord.
No, they were not the count.
Paste. There you go.
Thank you.
Yep.
So sound will come back before video. You're going to have to give me a second, guys. If sound comes back at all, it's loading.
By the way,
now.
It's loud, so...
I'll turn it down a bit.
They're showing some...
There we go.
What is this?
That... I don't know what that is. Sorry, look... Why can't I leave? Well, give me a second to fix the video, guys.
Oh, it's Destiny 2.
Oh, nobody cares about that.
Yeah, that was a powerful new look at Destiny 2. Oof. Forsaken is coming
out. Okay, we didn't miss anything. It's just Destiny 2.
A lot of great enhancements and content for that one. And,
Yeah, it looks really good. There's a lot of buzz about that Gambit mode coming up. And guess what?
God,
if you're at
E3,
you can play it at
stream is just gone.
Not too bad.
But
not too bad.
There's barely any
sorry about the technical issues, guys.
That's right. We are really seconds away
if
when
I
it comes
actually
down to
there,
the rest of PlayStation's E3 showcase.
I am
thank
actually
you so
here.
Much for watching.
Technically
it's
not
got a lot more
showcase,
in store tonight.
But still.
Yeah.
But...
And
for
even
now,
I, can't do anything about that.
I think it's almost time.
I think it's almost time.
Okay,
should
yeah,
we get to it?
I think, why keep people waiting? Let's get to it. We have so much more to cover.
We're back in time for the next games. That's what I'm happy about.
So let's check it out live right now.
Yeah, it's much louder. You notice it's actually at half. I'll turn it down a little bit more.
I've got to turn it down just a bit more.
Yeah, I'm guessing this is Death Stranding.
This has got to be.
I mean, I also wouldn't mind a Superman made by Platinum Games. I'm just saying, Bowman. Superman game, I mean. Yeah, I know, Nova Knight. This is... If we hadn't already done so like 3 times over on the Ubisoft conference, this would qualify as wasting money on stunts.
Wait, Ubisoft was just wasting money on stunts?
Oh, God. Like, they had great games, but... Like, they were showcasing Mario XCOM's DLC, which looks great... While a live band played and the camera focused on the band, just to use an example. And they just kept doing stunt after stunt. God. Anyways.
That's awful.
I do too, Bowman. Trust me. I know what you mean. I say without hyperbole or meme that Saints Row 4 is the best Superman game we've ever gotten. Does anyone know what instrument that is?
No idea.
I'm pretty sure I've actually seen one before, but I don't know what it's actually called.
Haven't they done something like this every single freaking year? For the past 3 years.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because they did it with God of War.
Yep.
They did it with...
Ashakuhachi?
Assassin's Creed?
I don't remember, but they did do it the year before. I remember that. Because
there was a lot of sand in the last one. Mm-hmm. I remember that. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, to my knowledge, we don't know what Death Stranding is at all. I'm presuming it's like Silent Hill-esque.
Yeah.
That's pure presumption.
They begin with music, but they're doing it for every game now.
Yeah.
That's...
Usually they start conferences with music, not games, but mm-hmm. whatever.
If you want to start with music, that's fine, but, like, we're here to see games, we're not here to see some guy perform.
This might be the samurai game that we don't know much about.
Ghost of Tsushima? Is that the one?
Yeah, I think.
Ooh.
The temple's close.
Gameplay. Mongol invasion, day 9. Cool.
This looks really, really good.
Yeah, I'm mesmerized by the grass.
Yeah.
The bricks on that grass is amazing.
The bricks on the grass. God damn it.
That's pretty.
Ooh, wow. I might just have to buy this just for the aesthetics.
I mean, if I could get rid of the UI and the character, I'm just saying.
Yeah.
There's always a use for that.
Nobu, come!
Wait a minute. Is this just an Ocarina of Time remake? Now, the Mongols invaded Japan several times, did they not?
Yes, they did.
And there were issues each time.
Mm-hmm.
Where are they?
But yes, it looks like we are finally getting a feudal Japanese game.
No, I agree, Rigel. This is about the right time for it, too. Witcher 3 came out, was massively successful, then people started copying it, and now they're done.
Yeah.
They have concluded the games they were working on. And yes, I know about the typhoons. Interesting.
Ooh, is it going to strictly be... Okay, I was going to ask if it's strictly counter-based, but it doesn't look like it.
No. I'm watching the movements of the sword, though.
Yeah, so am I.
Oh,
Okay, that was definitely a counterattack.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. So far, I am with it.
Jin, you're late.
You're impatient. Where's the monk?
The bastards beat me to him. Now they're torturing him at the temple.
Come on.
I don't think the Mongols deserve a lot of mercy.
He's a hero.
Black Vial.
We need him, Masako. Down.
We can take them.
No. Remember Sago Bridge? We strike quietly. And they kill the monks.
Yeah, I'm eating this up so far. I wonder.
This is my type of thing.
Yeah. Now I wonder if quests actually have like a fail state. Like, what if they did kill the monk? Could you keep playing, or would you have to reload the mission?
Just get them.
For some missions, I could see that flowing smoothly into a fail state. For some others, I because there has to actually be a way to win the story, you know?
Yeah.
And, like, not lock yourself out of it.
Yeah.
Oh my god, shut up out there. Good god.
Please. I do not understand. Urvathwi, Chamakotun Hami, Usmi Cheyavan Sakt, Chiobelatno. Do you see my
sorry. That looked like a mechanic where, like, it basically allows you to select your next target. Like a combo thing. Chain kill. Yeah. Chain kill.
He called reinforcements. We have to move.
Here, let me get this knife out of you. As weird as this may sound, I like the casualness of the violence.
Masako!
Stand aside.
Because it reinforces the
you betrayed my
warfare
family.
Period.
Run!
If we fight, Mongols win.
They already won.
Yeah, I like the lack of fantasy as well.
A purely realistic game like this is right up my alley these days. I haven't paid much attention to Kingdom Come. Was that like that?
Yes. And it is a very good game. I highly recommend.
Cool. I'll definitely check that out.
Yeah, she's actually Cypher, guys. This isn't minimalistic HUD or UI. There is zero UI on this screen.
Yeah, there's nothing. I really wonder how they're gonna do it.
You hear them coming? That's our enemy.
Because if there's gonna be no UI unless you actually like pause or something, that's an interesting design decision.
I suppose I shouldn't say literally no UI. There was a clear selector for the targeting earlier.
Okay, but otherwise.
But otherwise, yeah.
Yeah. Literally the most minimal you can get.
Ghost of Tsushima.
I will, yeah, definitely take a look at that. Oh my god. Oh, I might buy that day one.
And that's going to be on the PC, right?
God, I hope so.
It's...
Let's be honest, it's not.
I know, I'm joking. This is all Sony exclusive stuff. Or, excuse me, PS4 exclusive stuff. And a banana. At least they're not changing buildings this time.
Yeah.
Anything weird is just automatically Death Stranding.
The oldest house.
Show me Norman Reedus.
Is a shifting place. There are rules and rituals. You can keep traveling deeper.
What in the world?
No, we know this is weird, Max Time. We can
this
say
is weirder this than is Death weird. Stranding.
From the nightmares of Hideo Kojima. And the acid trip from last week.
What in the world am I looking at?
I just told you.
I mean, it's cool. It's cool. But what?
It's okay. It's actually all parasites.
It looks almost like she's got gravity gun type powers, which I'm down with.
No, the parasites give her those powers. She doesn't have a gravity gun.
Well, no, I know she doesn't literally have a gravity gun.
Okay.
Control. Okay.
I don't even have anything to say about that. It's weird.
Yeah, that's something.
Control. Next year. Okay.
Huh.
Cool. What else you got? Oh god, it's Cyberpunk again. Sweet, sweet Hello. Beer.
Anybody there?
Something not right.
Pizza.
What are we playing as a cat? Jesus.
I was thinking a rat, actually.
Or that, yeah.
Hey, well, relax. Everything on there. Can't be here.
Yeah, it sounded like a squeak.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
The poor rat.
Stay back, sir! I've got this! Officer, you need help? What are you doing? Get off! No! Get off of me!
Okay. Well, I didn't need to see that.
I wonder if this is the outlet I'm using. Because Pale's battery's running low, and I've literally got this connected. Give me a moment.
Oh, Resident Evil 2. Wow. I'm actually a little surprised by that.
Money's in my account. Always a pleasure.
Attention, all citizens. Due to the citywide outbreak.
And don't make my mistake. If you see one of those things, uniform or not, you do not hesitate.
Yeah, I was gonna say, show me a tyrant.
It takes to save the city.
I want to see a tyrant.
Surprised you made it this far.
I would also like to see Nemesis, but he wasn't here at this point.
Survival's your responsibility.
God damn it.
So, it might not be my laptop that's the problem, guys.
Good, bad?
Will you help
Good
me?
Good and bad. The good is, the other outlet works. Bad is, I wasted $70 on a universal charger.
Jeez.
Yeah.
But we never meant for this to happen.
Oh, man.
I can't remember what the tongue guys are called.
Live. Alive, please. Thank
it's
you.
Coming.
There we go.
It's coming back.
Liquors, thank you. Resident Evil 2. Are you calling it anything different? I mean, it looks like a proper remake, so I'm with it.
Hey, that comes out the same day as KH3. At least in Japan. Next time, get a $3 outlet tester. Yeah, Lurker, we went to Office Depot.
There is no such thing.
There's nothing tech-focused going on.
Yeah, I hope that's a timed exclusive, too. Yeah, that definitively qualifies as new game with the same name as old game.
Yeah.
That's unquestioning. We haven't had translator issues yet.
From Squanch Games and the co-creator of Rick and Morty.
Hey, what's up, everybody? I'm Bathtub Guy, and we're here at E3 to take some looks at this new game I'm going to show you right now. Trover Saves the Universe. Let's give it a look.
Don't play with electricity. What?
Disclaimer, do not play with electricity in the bathtub.
Ah, there we go.
I'm the bathtub guy. I'm always in my bathtub, but, you know, that's not about me right now. It's about this game. Whoa, look at that. That's exciting footage I just saw. Oh, I'm playing it right now. Look at me. I'm a cool cucumber over here playing this cool game. Jesus Christ. Oh my God. Somebody call 711 because that's the emergency dial number for this in this weird part of the galaxy because this is a sci-fi based thing. Help. He's got electrocuted.
Yeah, it's definitely very Rick and Morty-ish. You can actually hear his voice, too.
I don't like Rick and Morty style of humor. So.
I like Rick and Morty style of humor, but that was just kind of eh.
I don't know what this is. I've never even heard of this.
What is this?
Yo, it's different. Guys, it's different! Like we called it! We totally called it.
We get to be pirates again.
Oh, yep.
Wait, why?
See?
Still, it's a real shame we don't have a bigger ship.
Ooh. Oh, we're going into Davy Jones's locker.
Yes!
At least they look better now. Wow, they look way better now. Damn.
They're bringing in,
dude!
Oh my God!
All right, nope. You win. You win. Fine. Just take my money. Just whatever.
Jesus Christ!
You knew how to sell me.
Pirates. Now is this Pirates 2 and Pirates 3?
Yep.
Yeah. No, it totally does look like it. I love Sora's outfit.
I love how Sora's a pirate. Oh, my.
Oh, that looks so cool. It looks like there's enough mobility that fighting above and below the water is mobile as hell. Luxord!
Yes. Surprising, isn't it?
That's the same.
Okay, so where's Demix? He's the only one that's missing.
Don't you give this creep the time of day.
Sora, stand down. It's the code. Mustn't strike a pirate aboard ship. When said pirate offers to confabulate.
He sounds way better than he did it.
I am looking for a box.
Goddamn! Sora!
The Titans look awesome. They were there for a millisecond, but they look awesome.
Oh no!
Stop! Farewell! Arendelle is safer with me staying up here.
Oh,
please, go away!
Show off Big Hero 6, please.
Oh, I know. We've never seen gameplay of that, if I'm not mistaken. We've seen a screenshot.
You're following her.
Maybe she's one of the seven pure lights we need. The new seven hearts.
No.
Set your heart free.
Oh, that's creepy.
Oh, that is so creepy.
What destiny has in store for you. In fact, your reward might be right around the corner.
Hey, Axel.
Huh? Hey, liking the look.
Oh my God.
So there's her new outfit finally.
She's got short hair. Oh, she looks great.
And they're still calling him Axel. So, there's no way. That can't be Replico. That can't be Replico. That doesn't make sense.
What?
That's got to be a memory or something. Oh, my God. Okay, I'm sorry. I have to talk during this. I have to talk during this because this song is super copy wrong. So I'm just going to kind of keep a narrative thing going here. I'm very curious exactly... apparently it's going to contain 3, 1.5, and 2.8, so that's awesome. And 2.5, I saw that as well. Okay, I can shut up now. That's Rax, right there. That's Rax. The guy in the middle. That's Rax. Ew. No, seriously, ew. Go away. Go away.
Go away.
This is Death Stranding.
Yeah.
Porter Breaches.
Is that part of it?
The man who delivers. Tears. Chiral allergy. So, you have dooms, like me. What's your level?
I've got the extension factor. But I think you got me beat.
You can see him, right?
No, but I can sense him.
Wanna come work for me? Must be tough out here on your own.
I can't keep with that. I make deliveries. That's all.
So yeah, I was gonna say, maybe we're finally gonna see some actual gameplay for this. Like, all I know about this is that it's a weird game. That's it. And yeah, this is probably going to copy wrong. I'm sorry, but I'm going to talk a little bit over this to try and protect my... like, is he an excavator? A scavenger? Like, this looks vaguely like gameplay, just not normal gameplay, right? You notice he has a different outfit in most of these. And, of course, a different area he's going to. That's horrible. Yeah, it definitely looks like the Metal Gear Solid 5 engine. I'm not sure if it literally is or not, it just looks a lot like it. So, what happened is the robot revolution went bad, everyone died, The Last of Us happened, and then all of them died, and now the only thing left is like seven people and Norman Reed, and he's the one who has to carry stuff between those seven people. Got it. And then Fallout happens, but that's actually during the game. Like, in the middle of the game, the bombs fall, and those seven people go away. I don't want to look at that. I don't want to look at that. Nope. I have actually had that happen to me. I don't want to remember that. Okay. I think that's actually part of the video. I don't think I'm losing connection there. And then he gets the red virus. It turns him into a Klingon.
The
He was being quiet, lady. It's okay, they can't detect you unless you feel fear. I hope none of you get that reference. Since he's not literally not there right now, let's get rid of that for the moment.
Yourself. Those things never stay gone for long.
Yeah, Rax is dead, guys.
Time will fast forwards whatever it touches. But it can't wash everything away. The past just won't let go. I'll see you around. Sam Porter Bridges.
You?
Sam, what's your status? Kyrellium density is still increasing.
My status is fucked. There's tons of them.
Can you sit out the rain?
No. They're closing in on my position. I have to move before they realize I'm in here.
Sam, if one of those things eats you, it'll trigger a void out. You'll come back, sure. But the surrounding area will still be a crater.
What? So we can just resurrect?
I got an idea.
Hang on, we can't hear you. Or he's just... Okay. I don't know what he's doing. So we can resurrect because we have a baby. But we'll trigger a void out. That's when the really dark dreams get you. What in God's name is going on here? There's the things. Loverly things. Yeah, only babies can detect the ghost time things. Because, well, I mean, let's just be 100% honest. Because Kojima. That's not an insult. Don't jump down my throat. That is just Kojima. They found him. He's dead. Void out! And he comes back! Oh, God, what'd I miss?
A crypto void a day keeps the time fall away.
No, I can't listen to that. Okay, we're okay.
Too late. You still don't know who I am, do you?
Yeah, you're Lindsay Wagner. I am the Prophetess Itine.
All right, sorry about that. Just...
You're missing the creepy weird stuff. Guys, do me a favor and don't make me play that game. Please. I can't hear you. Can you hear me, Rax?
You can't hear me.
I can hear you, but I can't hear you, if you follow.
How's this?
Still quiet. Oh. Which is weird.
That is very strange.
You're still at full on my end, so I don't know. No, I am not using reverse psychology. Please do not make me play that game. That game is something I don't think I can deal with. So this looks like Neo. Two. Okay, there you go. Ooh. You're just super quiet. Like, I can hear you.
I can turn the gain up.
Nah, it's fine. What I really want to know is when you're buying a Kingdom Hearts PlayStation 4.
As soon as it becomes available.
It's not on Amazon, for reference.
Yeah,
I already checked.
I know. We will find it. We will post it. We will find it. Oh, Square wins E3, guys.
So, we were totally right about up top, Rex. Up top. We were totally right about that.
Totally. New trailer. Like, yep. Every single conference.
At each one
matter.
Of them. Yep.
The raft is secure, so, but I can't reach them over radio. Sora for their Smash? Must
be down. That would What's be awesome. Status? I'm going to say yes. I'm just going to say it right now. I'm committing to it. Spidey! Spidey!
I thought you said it was secure.
It was. Let's go. Maybe it's not as bad as it looks.
Love the optimism. But in my experience, when it looks bad, it's usually worse. Look out!
Do you remember me? Sorry, bad movie.
Hold on!
I like the look of Electro. We only saw him for a second, but I liked it.
Yeah, yeah. I'm gonna have to rewatch me freaking out to Kingdom Hearts on
you
your
okay?
stream.
Yeah.
It was quite cool amusing.
Welcome to the park! Just in time for the fireworks!
Looks like we made parole, boys!
Did you clip it, Bregwin?
Why is he letting everyone
You should link that on
me?
Discord, Bregwin.
Please do. Please
Got
do.
It. I'll go join the party.
Yeah, I'll want to look at it later. I want to watch this right now. Here we go! Gameplay. Oh, let me move Rax. There we go. So, we've got a combo meter.
Oh, you're moving me.
Yeah, I want to see the UI. I want to see the UI. This looks really Arkham, and I like it.
Yeah, this looks Arkham as hell.
I really like it.
If you're combining Arkham with Spider-Man 2...
I mean, Arkham City was basically a Spider-Man game anyways, so I'm with it.
Ooh.
There's the use of the combo thing he was building in the upper left.
Yeah.
You can make me play this one, guys. It's okay.
Oh.
So here's Rhino.
I will buy this thing when I'll play it.
You like surprise, I like how Rhino looks.
Surprise? What is he talking about?
Now I wish I'd pre-ordered for the Iron Spider. Spider
Just trapped in a prison with every criminal I've put away in the last 8 years. No biggie.
There's Scorpion.
Must be working for someone.
This is too good to be true.
Scorpion, can you hold on a minute? I was in the middle of a phone call and it was business.
I wonder if they're gonna bring in, like, Doc Ock, or...
I don't know. I mean...
Or Vulture.
I don't think not Rhino's really. Part of the Six, so it's not that.
Mm.
Not really. Electro is.
Electro, Rhino, and now Scorpion are all on the loose. What's going on in the rest of the prison?
Camera system's almost done. I'll give you a sit rep soon.
Okay, I'll keep tracking Electro.
So it looks like the web shooter regenerates over time. Which I like that mechanic.
Yeah.
It means you have ammo, but not, like, totally finite.
It's, yeah, nah, yeah.
You just need to think about when you use it.
Come on, Spider-Man! I thought this was a chase!
Seriously, he looks so
stop
cool.
This guy.
Yeah, no, I'm liking this. I'm really liking this. That also looked like gameplay, which I also like. This looks more like contextual, QTE.
Go easy on you. Can't stop it. Try. Nobody ever takes me up on that offer. Gotcha.
There's Vulture.
Vulture, what?
Nice. Called it.
Although I still like the movie Vulture better.
Sorry,
but...
no time to talk.
Yeah, I like the movie Vulture's design, but
yeah. But that is a good Vulture. That is a good Vulture.
Because that's more like a fusion of old culture and MCU.
It's not working, guys. I'm not sure what's wrong. Come on, Doc Ock. Doc's always been one of my favorites, actually.
Yeah. They gotta bring in Doc Ock or Green Goblin.
I'm kinda am Goblin, honestly.
Well, yeah, but Goblin is like...
He's super iconic, yeah.
And where's Mysterio? We still haven't seen him.
Mysterio's behind it all. Maybe, I don't know.
Well, yes, I know, but like... Mysterio is like the villain for this game. Or so we've said. Or so we've said.
Still gameplay.
Yeah, and also I actually think slow-mo works for like Spidey senses. Like that, so
agreed.
I'm pretty okay with this. God, this might actually surpass Spider-Man 2 for the best Spider-Man game. That's awesome.
Where'd you get it? It's an exclusive club.
So there's inverted guy from earlier. We already knew about him. That looks like a fun fight.
Remember, he said not to kill him.
Good idea. In fact, we don't have to do this at all if you don't want to.
We definitely want to.
Ow.
Oh.
So again, still Arkham City.
Get the hell out of there.
You?
Cut away. Oh, yeah, damn. I knew they were gonna do that. Where's my pen? There it is. It's Aunt May. By the way, spoiler alert.
I honestly think it might be Harry Osborn. Or not Harry Osborn.
Norman.
Harry.
Norman or Harry?
I think they should be terrified.
Harry. Because okay. He's got the different blood.
Oh, here's the conclusion.
You do not hesitate.
Yo, Kingdom Hearts!
What? There was Kingdom Hearts at this?
Maybe I'm in a really good mood. Because every conference knocked it out of the park. We know Nintendo's gonna knock it out of the park.
Of course every they are.
Has
Nintendo has never failed to knock it out of the park to some extent or another. At least at this stuff. Obviously, and Nintendo fails all the time. That's not relevant. I mean, it is relevant. Shut up. Meanwhile, not there.
That was the PlayStation E3 showcase. A lot to take in. There was a ton of great worldwide studios titles.
What the hell did I just see?
Here, coming right up, we're going to have first live gameplay of Marvel Spider-Man right here. Just a couple of minutes. We have a new game to announce.
I'm gonna leave the recording going.
Yeah, because
what a show.
Yeah.
Oh,
I figured they'd do a gameplay section. It's kind of, after last year, it's kind of become the thing. I just didn't know which game they were gonna do.
Absolutely incredible. That color palette was insane.
Yeah.
Did you grow up with Samurai?
Did you
movies?
See the trailer, Myra?
Absolutely. Yeah.
I'm ready. It's just the embodiment.
I'm ready. Sucker punch.
It was a good trailer.
It was a good trailer.
With a decent amount of new stuff and a significant amount of new info.
A lot of us fans have been waiting for that one.
In fact, they had new new scenes of previous scenes.
And then as soon as he turned his head, I was like, yes.
And you get that RE4 style.
We have seen very little.
That's kind of like the ultimate dream if they were going to remake Resident Evil 2.
Yeah,
that's what
exactly.
I want. So
like we saw Larkscene, but she was saying new stuff. We saw Zigbar. Yeah.
Death Stranding.
Elsa, but otherwise,
we now have more questions.
Yes,
more questions.
It looks as if, I mean, I don't want to make any promises.
We're probably going to talk about Kingdom Hearts at some point, Myron.
Allusion to a lot of gameplay and kind of what the character of Sam is going to be doing in this very unusual.
So we had The Last of Us 2, which looked pretty good.
Scary things.
Ghost of Tsushima, which looked amazing.
Ghost of Tsushima looks.
Babies.
Resident Evil 2, proper remake. I'm totally with that. I mean, Death Stranding, no. Death Stranding, please don't make me play that. Spider-Man looks really, really good.
We got a lot of other great stuff. We had a new Remedy game. Remedy's on the way.
A new world to Kingdom Hearts 3. A new world announced.
I want to learn more about that one. I mean, it just looks like
wizards
and, like, I don't know what
No, we don't. It's the weirdest thing. It was the first thing they announced, and we have never actually seen it for real.
Olympus Entangled Campus.
Oh, you're right.
Legendary villain.
But it was among the first.
It was
like right there at the beginning.
2015 or 2016. Like right there.
Now this is interesting.
Welcome back. We just saw Sony's E3 2018 press conference. There was a lot of gameplay in there and a lot to break down. So we're going to get right to it. I'm Callie. I'm joined by Michael Hyam.
Hello.
Jake Decker.
Oh, this is GameSpot.
What up?
Let me see if I can find.
Yeah, I'd rather have a direct. Maybe Twitch is working now. No, I haven't heard anything about Kingdom Hearts 3 Collector's Edition. What are you talking about, Cool Walker?
I totally haven't heard anything about a Kingdom Hearts PS4. Nope.
It definitely doesn't come with Kingdom Hearts 1.5, 2.5, 2.8, and 3. That is not a thing. That is true.
I still can't believe it. How much is it going to cost? Is it going to be $400? Am I going to have to buy that?
Probably more.
Can I sell my PS4 to one of you guys?
I'm afraid not. Now, so this is the GameSpot. Let me see if I can find it.
I'm looking at PlayStation Europe, but they're doing something weird.
Give me a second. Let's get rid of this for a second. Boop. Let's just get rid of that. Let me see if I can find what they're doing. And it have it open. There we go.
Oh, you had a link?
Their Twitch is working again.
Oh, cool. I will go ahead and open that.
Yeah, I gotta completely change everything back over because I just changed everything over to the YouTube side of things. God damn it. There's a cat, guys. Spoiler alert.
Wait, they're announcing a new thing?
I have no idea what this is. I didn't have audio until it was already starting. Give me a minute. I'm sorry, guys. Give me a minute.
There's a cat.
Yep, there is a cat. And there's, like, not grayscale, but whatever that's called.
No, it's
sepia-toned.
Sepia-toned, and it's got film grain.
Yeah.
Interesting.
And there's a flower, and there's energy going through the flower, and there's a Deracine? I have no idea what that
Any
means.
Any idea on the release date for the limited edition PS4 Pro? No idea. It's not even on Amazon yet. I'd imagine it's going to be maybe a day or so. Who knows?
Debut, I would say. Yeah. And speaking of compelling,
there we go.
Let's get to that Spider-Man. It is time.
We have some folks from Insomniac
here.
We do. Brian, Adam, gentlemen.
There.
Hey, how are you guys
doing? Okay.
FromSoft is doing a PSVR game?
Is that what that was?
That's what they said.
Kind of closing out some of the show there with.
I was hoping for some Spider-Man gameplay.
Here we go. Here we go, Spider-Man.
We've been working on it for a while, so it's nice to be here. And obviously, we showed you people wanted villains.
Agreed, Roy Ting.
We'll give you a lot of villains, and now.
See you around, Ceramax.
Next question is: can we play the open world? And Adam's gonna show off.
Outside KH3, Sony or SE don't have much going for them right now. I beg to differ.
Yeah, I disagree.
Both
Square has tons of games coming out right now.
Yeah, and that's just two. Nier Automata, Definitive Edition, basically.
The ongoing Life is Strange series is still continuing.
Life is Strange spinoff actually looks good.
Tomb Raider's coming out.
Tomb Raider,
Octopath.
Definitely Octopath. No Deus Ex this year. I'm surprised.
Yeah, me too.
Let's go to that footage. We have it running here on the main monitor. We'll go to it in just a second. This is the beauty of the live.
There we go.
Yeah, this. Oh God.
Oh, this is great. I got my own little TV.
So here's what wandering around the world looks like. It looks roughly incredible.
that's right.
And again, live gameplay, which I do prefer. Here, let's.
Oh my god, this web slinging.
Here, let's do this really quick so you can see as much of the game as possible here.
That's.
So there's. So he's got a tutorial up, as you can see there. And it does look like it's very much. This is super Arkham City, in a good way. Chain this into that, into this, into that.
Experience that. So. You know, obviously, it's a big narrative-driven experience.
It's Arkham City in a universe I actually care about. I mean, no offense to DC. DC's cool, but I'm nowhere near as invested in DC as I am in Marvel.
Yeah.
He's one of our combat pro players, because he's a combat designer, and again, he's just showing off some really awesome stuff.
Yeah, I like how... This is great. This is exactly what I want. I want you to just show off gameplay. Thank you, like, Sony.
I really wonder if, like, they're going to do a lot of, like, references to other Marvel properties and stuff like that. Like they did in the Spider-Man animated series.
I mean, it is easier to do that in a game than a movie. And even the movie has kind of been... hammering those rights issues out. So.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So there's activities.
Guys, I didn't know you could do that. So I think there's a lot of that. There's that sandbox nature to it as well. So I mean, obviously.
I don't know what any of these are, but you can see. And I like that they're color coded. Also, if you notice, not each color is the same icon. So not all the green things have the same icon to them.
Really allows for a lot of different gameplay. A lot of, you know. Spider-Man's a very expressive character. We want players to be able to express that, whether it's in traversal or in combat.
See, this is where I think, you know, I want a world that's four times the size of Fallout 4, because there's actually stuff to do in it.
Yeah, no
kidding. Even if there's not, like... I don't want to say not content, because that's disingenuous. But you know what I mean.
I do. Also, I like how we do the superhero landing.
Spyro to Ratchet to Sunset Overdrive.
Yep. And I mean, so it looks like you do things to earn upgrades. Came out, one person not a big shock there. It would be great to see Arkham City, excuse me.
I love Deadpool so much.
We took that kind of mentality and we just injected our kind of our personality, but also...
Uh-oh, we found a Fisk hideout. Which means Fisk is, to some extent or another, in this.
They kind of confirmed that last year.
I know, it's just... I mean... I'm trying to think of what a phrase...
I get what you're saying.
My brain isn't here. It's over there with Kingdom Hearts
3. My brain is over there chilling with that new PS4. I mean, just the
fluidity of just moving over great. If I'm being completely honest, I probably won't pick that up. I own all of those games and a PS4 Pro with a custom SSD already put into it. But that is still awesome.
If I have money to burn.
So there's the focus bar thing that I mentioned earlier.
I might do something for you.
That's so awesome. The focus bar thing. Oh, ow! When I play other games, we're good.
Are you all right?
My leg literally slipped in like a hard way, and so I nailed my bad leg on like the edge of my footrest. Yeah, that actually hurt, but I'm cool. It just hurt.
Hold on a second. Okay. Very interesting what you're saying there.
So like I said, so Adam showed off. I think he showed off the tripwire. It's basically a gadget that you can either attach to. Piece of geometry.
Did he just throw that guy off the roof?
Yeah.
I mean, he's not Batman, so he can kill people.
Yeah.
Yeah, so the focus meter is basically, there's kind of a risk reward. As you build focus, you can use it to heal.
I like how you can launch people in midair and then kick them off. That's
the
awesome.
The team worked really, really hard on it. Really, really hard. Clearly. And the idea is the focus is kind of a way to... it's a risk reward. Like I said, you can either heal yourself or you can kind of, if you get fill up the bar a certain way, you can actually pull off a finishing move. So, you know,
that's cool.
This is so awesome.
So for those of you who didn't quite hear that, the focus bar can be used for an ultimate or a heal. And that is an excellent thing.
With his experience being under the mask for so many years now.
Yep. 8 years.
Suit powers? Interesting.
Well, yeah, we've obviously got some kind of mecha suit.
I wonder if they if they're gonna take cues from Homecoming and say, hey, this was designed by Stark.
I don't know. I mean,
I mean, Peter is a genius, and he's definitely a little bit older in this game.
Oh yeah, absolutely. I wonder who's voicing him. Options, right? You want to make it approachable. One thing I noticed too, and again, this kind of goes back to City. This is clearly further on in the mythos. Like for all of his, you know, for that particular villains crowd to all be locked away in prison already. Yeah, there's established history here.
Punch guys up in the air and use your webs, but then we layer on things like gadgets. And then
and specifically locked away in the raft.
Just,
I mean,
it's kind of giving over time. If we just, you know, one thing with some like E3, you know, we want you to feel
now
great.
That's probably
right?
All they're going to show off.
Really
yeah. That's awesome.
We kind of find those spots in the game where it makes
sense. Yuri Lowenthal. Yeah. Oh, I guess I could put me back on screen
here.
I am
super okay with that.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Sid, what do you think?
I gotta say, this game is beautiful, looking right? Absolutely gorgeous. This is.
They're probably gonna keep talking about stuff.
But this is on a totally different level. And
oh,
I can
man,
just
we're
see
seeing
that,
so much.
I can
oh,
see
please
that
tell me your Kingdom Hearts 3
thing,
finish.
And that's what comes out in that final few months of development.
Yeah, I mean.
Honestly, probably not. I'm not trying to sound negative.
No,
they just probably don't.
If they don't have Kingdom Hearts 3 footage, I will get your Kingdom Hearts 3 footage, guys.
Most likely this is going to be a PS4 exclusive, yes. Also, you can do challenges, and you get better rewards the better you do. Very Saints Row-y there.
They had a similar thing in Spider-Man 2, so not really that surprised, but that's pretty cool.
I mean, what's it like for you and for the team to be able to kind of look up at the big screen and see...
So, can I just say that one of the things I personally have always felt that Spider-Man games have failed at is the movement, the getting from point A to point B. Spider-Man 2 on the PS2 is like one of the only exceptions to that.
One of the only exceptions. Even like Spider-Man 3, which was supposed to be a successor to Spider-Man 2 in that regard, but this looks like it's...
Yeah, this looks like they've nailed the transport, and that's awesome. As I pointed out during Shadow of War, one of the most important parts of any open-world game, in my opinion, is the transport.
How you get around.
Yeah, point A to point B is very important. It needs to be fun, it needs to be fluid, and it needs to be as free as possible for the player.
Sony, Marvel, but also the fans.
I missed it. God damn it.
It just looks incredible. I mean, there's no
I like how they've got that free fall thing going on.
Yeah, I really am. It's stunning. I mean, just look at that. How can you not be blown away by that? But we do have a limited amount of time here. Brian, you're an industry veteran. You've been in the industry for a long time. I know this is a lifelong dream for you working on this game. And I want to thank you and Insomniac for making it.
So is that all we got? Is there any other gameplay?
Spider-Man was so awesome that it broke my mic, and I have to use the stick mic now.
Me too, J-Mon.
I just wanted to stand out a little bit. Yeah. But, you know, Sid, actually, I think a little earlier we were able to maybe get some footage of some of the amazing experiential stuff that's going on with Spider-Man.
Right? I mean, experiential? Really incredible going on here.
Experiential.
That's the word he just said.
It's on a scale and a scope that we have just never seen before, and so we have...
Apparently, there's going to be Spider-Man playable. By the way, hand-to-hand racks. Oh, yeah. Do you have your pen and paper or phone or whatever nearby? I want to add a game to your thing. They mentioned it during the PC Gaming Conference.
Give me a moment.
There's familiar faces popping up. That's right.
I do still need to add Blades, and I need to add one more game.
Everybody in here to try this out and to just see what has
Elder
been sort of constructed with Spider-Man and with
Blades.
Actually, another game we're about to talk about.
Yeah, we're about
to. There was another game. I think it was an
indie game?
I think. They showed it off during Xbox, but I can't remember it.
Hang on, there's my Xbox stuff. That was back here. Jump Force, Stunlight, Just Cause, Gears of War. Cyberpunk?
Wasn't Cyberpunk.
Tunic.
Cyberpunk is literally at the top of my list.
Tunic.
Like for you as
Tunic. That's it.
Okay.
Developers to be able to kind of be a part of.
Thank you.
Of all of this.
So, I just realized you actually didn't catch the Ubisoft one either, did you?
No.
So, Starlink might be there.
Ah, yes. And I tried to get that last year.
And has Star Fox in it?
Oh man, it's
as in Star Fox. Star Fox.
As in Star Fox.
You see all the other projects and
so if you could add that one to your list,
Ubisoft trying to go second party.
I mean,
I guess
it's just great.
I think we should.
They've also got Assassin's Creed Odyssey, which looks really, really good.
Also at the top of my list.
And the other one I would have tossed at you was a game called Overwhelm, I think? I was scribbling it down hastily. Anyone remember what I'm talking about? Because I don't remember what that is off the top of my head. But also the I don't either.
Sophistication as Hang well. On. I mean, we're going to see here in a minute. Here we go. There we go. Get into some combat.
Yeah, we have some
okay, here we go. Gameplay of Ghost of Tsushima.
First time.
Look
yeah.
at this. Look at this.
Ooh. No, it is Overwhelm. It's a side-scroller punishing platformer looking game.
And maybe I don't
Ooh,
know
cool,
Jason
cool,
who
cool.
Wants to take
so
this
it is Overwhelm. I was right. I was right.
So yeah, my list is pretty big right now, guys.
Yeah, yeah.
In which you really focus in
also, Ghost of Tsushima should be on your list.
Ghost of Tsushima is near the top of my list. I forgot Cyberpunk is not for some reason.
I can only assume. It is a
Dying Light 2 playable? I don't know, Volcanto. In fact, honestly, we don't know how many of these games are playable at all. I mean, obviously Spidey is because they literally just show that.
Play everything. I do not have time. I will send pictures of these lines. I don't have the. That
oh yeah, the lines are. Whoo! He's going to have to pick and choose, guys. That's why prioritizing.
I will try to sort this. Maybe I'll put it up tonight and say, hey, vote on these.
Real quick, you're going to start hitting the floor tomorrow, right?
Tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning. Okay, so we won't know the Nintendo stuff before you hit the floor.
I am not going to be at the Nintendo, or I'm not going to be here for Nintendo, no.
Yeah. My point is, though, I almost guarantee you Nintendo's going to add to that list, if you know what I mean. Not counting Smash.
I feel like we're in a super unique position because, we're part of Sony. I play Smash in 2 days.
So, we'll see, I suppose. I'm definitely not checking Amazon again. I'm mostly curious about price at this point.
help us create this thing. Oh, the Joji screen.
Nintendo is... Hang on. Nintendo is 9 a.m. Pacific, which is noon
for us at 11, but obviously I want to be there earlier.
So noon Eastern. Deep in
development. But tell us a little bit about that. Well, we're going for lethal precision.
God, this game looks so goddamn good.
It looked. Oh my god.
I want to play this game.
And so every I want to play this so badly.
End of life, so you want to make sure that each one counts.
Yeah. I'm sorry, guys. You know my mind is just gone, but I.
So let's cover some stuff really quick. So I guess we already did. The Last of Us 2. I like the approach to stealth. I like the approach to the UI. I love that dodging is a thing. I'm curious why all the enemies are human. That's interesting to me. Ghost of Tsushima, the game that's on camera right now, stance-based combat, parry and counter-based, sword fighting, stealth, and drop-downs, virtually no UI with it. Resident Evil 2, I don't have anything to add to that. Of all the Resident Evils you're going to do a proper remake of, you do one of two. I agree with that. Like, the only other candidate is Nemesis, as far as I'm concerned, and 4. But 4 doesn't need a proper remake, because it's a great game.
I was going to say, 4 is fine.
4 is fine. 4 doesn't need a proper remake. Kingdom Hearts 3. Okay,
I think for me at least. 3 trailers? No.
Yeah. Yeah, 3.
4 trailers. I'm sorry, orchestra trailer, too.
Oh, you're right, I'm sorry.
We had that 4 trailers, release date, limited edition plus Bring Arts figures, limited edition PS4, they knocked it out of the park for me.
Oh yeah.
I'm figuratively circling that gorgeous.
Spider-Man, we talked about Spider-Man, I don't have anything new to add to that, that's awesome. Death Stranding, I'm going to think about this a little more, but I think I might remove that from my premiere runs list, guys. I really, without joking or exaggerating, I think that's just going to be too much for me. It's really, really weird and also really gross. And I think that's a little bit past me. I'm sorry, guys. I'm not deciding that right now. It's late. I'm tired. I will sit on that decision. But I think I might actually remove that from the premiere run list. I'm pretty sure it's actually on the list right now. Let me check my website.
People like funded that?
I'll check.
You may want.
I don't have that memorized. I have it all on my website.
So we had no idea what they were going
to do. Death Stranding is technically not funded. What I mean by that is the only money that's been put towards Death Stranding was put towards every game that was up simultaneously and evenly. So reallocating that is easy.
I mean, and we had the final word, right? The orange drummer.
Put that into Spider-Man, for example. Which actually, hang on.
No, I've been donating for Spidey.
Hang on. Actually, Sean donated today to Spider-Man, which actually caps it off. It's Spider-Man is now funded, guys.
It just felt like such a good
no joke. I'm not going to update the website right now. It takes forever. I'll do it later. But Spider-Man is funded. Frozen Synapse is funded. Both of those happened today. And that's it for the moment.
Put it towards Duskers. I'm kidding.
If I'm going to reallocate that, I'm probably... Well, I mean, it's technically going to the bank. But since I want to reallocate it immediately of this list... We've got
press is KH3 going to be on PC?
I think you can create anything. Literally people ask me like
I wish maybe in a couple of years.
Maybe in a couple of years is correct.
Oh my god, if they have like a bundle like that, not like a PS4-ish bundle, but like a 1.5 to 1.53, a 2.8 bundle.
We're debuting our new band, The Molecules.
I think I will reallocate that to Dragon Quest Builders 2.
Perfect. They will be using the create tools that you're watching right now to
is that you guys?
A 15-minute live
yeah, my roommates are still...
Okay, I'm just... I hear...
They keep freaking out.
It for the folks at home.
Yeah, man,
I'm sorry.
No, it's okay, I just didn't know what I was hearing. And that was a worrying sound. That's why I took my headphone out.
It almost sounded like someone was...
Yeah. It's like, okay, are you okay?
Yeah, I mean, it's like, it's super easy.
I'm sorry, what game is this?
What the hell am I looking at?
I don't know. I've been looking at my website, which is over there.
Is this like done with Move controllers? Or...
Jonotrino, hang on, let me pull up. Oh god, you're gonna make me do this. You're gonna make me do this. I hate you. Why are you making me do this? It's okay, I have a spreadsheet.
Do the gameplay, you can animate, you can record voice
overs. Okay, Death Stranding.
The whole thing on a PlayStation.
And just to clarify, sorry to interrupt.
Where is Death Stranding? There it is.
Two people, both
I don't have that down, Jonotrino. Was it Bits? Because that would make sense.
And it's quite funny, one of you can be testing and then...
Because this spreadsheet was going back and digging through logs, and I have zero logs for Bits. Literally zero. I don't get any information. If I don't write it down when it happens, I don't get it. So I'm going to go ahead and jot that down right now.
Sometimes people get a bit scared about the idea of the blank canvas.
How much was it?
For future reference, if you
donate bits. Choice. Like every day people make choices. You put your clothes on, you might put a poster in your bedroom.
And dreams
is I've been doing that since I started the spreadsheet. But anything before the spreadsheet didn't get grandfathered in. That's the problem. So, okay, Jonotrino, how much was it? I'm guessing it was 4. And... what would you like to put it towards instead?
Of the PlayStation 4 players' creations, you can, and we sort of presented to you in a stream.
What is this?
Who knows? I don't know. Like. I mean, that's what's so I'm confused by this.
I'm so confused.
We will be starting to see what the creativity of PlayStation
see you Blue Wolf, Alex.
Really means for dreams.
That's excellent. So beta
are we crafting here, dreams? Is that what's happening? Runner's choice. Thank you, Jonah Trina.
Instead of LSD Dream Emulator, we've got LSD Dream Crafter.
Innovative and oh god, that's a good point. Hang on, so... Alright, so...
Damn it, Terra actually beat me to it. Is this LSD the game?
So there's Jonotrino. I've jotted that down.
It is. Yeah, big cheers to the team.
Maz
big cheers to
gives
the team
2. Maz, 6, 8, 7. Assassin, AC, Odyssey. So we have a problem, guys. A lot of new games just got announced, and I have to decide how many of these get added to Premiere Run list.
Jamming with animators to actually make animation. I think that's one of the things we're really starting to see is these different workflows.
Okay, really wanted to get that right. We have Unravel 2.
All different types of genres of games, and really almost like come
first
up
one?
With completely
new
ways.
No, actually, I never had time. And I don't generally play games without those. So we got Unravel 2.
AC Odyssey.
Metro Exodus, I believe, is already on there. In fact, I think it's been funded. Yeah, it's been funded. It's right there.
I've actually got my list, if you want.
Forza Horizon 4? Question mark? Devil May Cry 5. Tunic. Dying Light 2. Just Cause 4.
Thank you so much.
And I can't wait to see more.
Doom 2. For more on the geek. Wolfenstein 3.
I think
Fallout 76, that one probably wouldn't get funded, but that is technically on the list.
Metal Wolf Chaos.
Rover Saves the Universe, which was
I mean, that's not a premiere run.
But wouldn't be a premiere run,
but that is probably something I will stream.
That should be a chill run.
Elder Scrolls Blades actually qualifies. I guess the new Tomb Raider, if people are interested in that. I will not do Captain Spirit. We don't know enough about those yet. I don't want to play Division 2 yet. Mario XCOM DLC, technically. Don't know about that yet. There's a lot of these that are just don't know. Assassin's Creed Odyssey, I need to add that to the list.
J-Mon? Like, what do I do? For the gaming industry and stuff like that?
He plays video games.
I'll explain it.
Wait, let me finish my list real quick. So we got Satisfactory. This is stuff you missed at the PC thing. Satisfactory, Star Control 3, Maneater, which looks really good.
What is that?
You play as a shark. It's an open world shark RPG.
Sold.
and then we have Jurassic World, which actually comes out tomorrow. Noida. Overworld, maybe. It's kind of, we'll see. Hitman 2. The Last of Us 2 is actually already on the list. Ghost of Tsushima. And that's everything. Okay, that's everything. God, that's a huge goddamn list of new games.
Okay. J-Mon, I'm a Kingdom Hearts community influencer. Basically, I write news articles for the game series Kingdom Hearts, and that has, for the past 2 years, given me the great fortune to attend E3. And last year, we've kind of set a trend of me, you know, coming onto the show and covering each of the games that I've seen, some of the games that I've played, stuff like that. And this year I've decided, well, we decided, hey, why don't we do the conferences too? Because, you know, I'm basically available for that.
Yeah. And you are literally more of a media person than I am.
Yes, Hardboiled One, KH13. Says on the shirt, actually.
Okay, there's the clip. I need to watch that later. The clip of you freaking out.
Oh my god. Dude, limit pale. Don't worry about it, but I have my reaction on my stream. I was streaming with Forerunner. Do you want to watch it on the TV? Okay. Later after we finish this.
Yeah, we're wrapping up right now. He'll
upload it to his channel, okay. But I'll clip it and put it on my channel as well.
Did you see Marluxia?
Marluxia?
The Japanese trailer. It showed like 1 or 2 seconds, and he's Norded. Oh, he has yellow eyes. Oh,
no. Did you hear that?
Apparently, Marluxia has been Norded.
Oh, God.
We're just going to keep calling it that? Is that where we're going with this?
I mean, it's been like that for years.
Yeah,
it's
but...
It's like 2010.
Okay, we're cool. Guys, Rax got Norded.
I don't have the eyes. Closest I've got is the lazy eye. I don't think that counts.
Okay, we're cool. I think we're good to chop off the local recording.
Yeah.
So, because I think they're just showing a making of here. Yeah. So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining me for the Sony conference. Tomorrow, Nintendo. Way too early. And yeah, I know it's at noon, but God, I'm tired.
Way too early? No, it's a little bit late for me. I'd gladly wake up at like... 7 to
oh, I'm waking the hell up. It might even be a good pre-show. Oh, speaking of which, Rex, wait, hang on. Let's chop off the recordings first. So, goodbye. And then I lose my